Hey guys, it's Jenny. Welcome back to the Crafting Bookworm. Today I'm going to do a tag for you. Okay, welcome back, y'all. Welcome, new subscribers. Thanks to all of you for your continued support. Whether you're here for books or crafts, I appreciate each and every one of you. So this is called the Mid-Year Freak Out Tag. Okay, this was originally created by, is that Cammy, I think it is. And then I was tagged by Elaine over at the Cobalt Dragon. So I will link to both of those channels down in the description box so you guys can go visit them. So let's just get started on here. The best book that you've read in 2024. And I've read a lot of good books so far. And I'm sure I'm going to read many more good books. But the first one that comes to mind for me is Genesis by Chris Carter. If you guys have been watching my videos or my book videos for very long, you know that I am just absolutely in love with his writing style. He writes thrillers and he doesn't sugarcoat anything. Like, you are right there in all of the mess. And Robert Hunter is our detective, and he works in the ultraviolet crimes unit where he works. And this is, you know, just the most grisly crime scenes that you'd ever come across. And Robert Hunter leads that. And there's been some pretty appalling crimes in this series. I believe this is book number 12, the last book that was out. This book came out in 2022, I believe. Fantastic. This is probably my favorite series of all, is this Robert Hunter thriller series. It's fantastic. You guys should give it a shot. Question number two is the best sequel that you've read this year. And that for me is going to be A Court of Silver Flames. I'm way behind on this, I know. But I finally got caught up and absolutely loved this. This is probably, it was 5-star rating. So I'm going to say it's probably my favorite of the series. But not my favorite series. My favorite series is the Throne of Glass series. But yeah, this was really, really good. Absolutely love the characters. And I love the writing style. The writing style is really fluid. You can see how big this book is, but I really, really enjoyed it. Number three is a new release you haven't read. And that one is going to be The Women by Kristen Hanna. Kristen, I adore her. I think I've read just about everything that she has written, and this one came out earlier this year, and I haven't had a chance to pick it up yet. I keep saying, oh, I'm going to read it, I'm going to read it. And I just haven't gotten to it, but I really want to read it this year because I hear really, really good things about it. And if it's any clue from the other books she's written, then I know that this is going to be fantastic as well. Okay, I'm trying to do this really quick, you guys. Number four, the most anticipated for the second half of 2024. And for me, that is A Curse for True Love, and this is by Stephanie Garber. You guys saw my wrap-up where I read Once Upon a Broken Heart, and then The Ballad of Never After, and then A Curse for True Love is number three. I haven't gotten it on my Kindle yet. I plan on doing it because that's the next book I want to read. I don't know if this is going to be just a trilogy. I haven't found anything else out about that, but I'm guessing that it is probably going to be the case. So that is the one I'm anticipating reading, and hopefully it will be within the next couple days. Okay, number five is the biggest disappointment of 2024, and for me that was definitely Darling Girl. This is by Liz Michalski, and this is kind of like a Peter Pan reimagining, and I felt like the content was okay, but I was expecting a little bit more from it. Like I said, it's a Peter Pan reimagining, but Peter is a part of the story and the characters, but not as you would see like in the movie. if that makes any sense. But it just didn't have enough. It was really kind of disappointing. I mean, the flow was okay, but yeah, like I said, I just wanted more. Okay, the next one here. The biggest surprise of 2024. And that for me was 29 seconds. This is by TM Logan. I picked this up years ago, you guys. And you don't hear anything about this book. And I had it on my shelf and I read the synopsis of it and said, you know what? I think I'm going to read that book. And it was pretty amazing. I think it was 4 or 5 stars and really, really enjoyed it because, you know, this woman is having a hard time with somebody and she gets this call. I think it's her, it's the workplace, the workspace that she works in. Alan is his name, and he pretty much controls the workplace kind of, and he's just really not a nice person. And she gets an offer from somebody, and they tell her, just give us a name because, you know, she saved, I don't want to say too much, she saved this man's child, this little girl, and he wanted to repay her, and he's not really a nice guy either. And he says, just give me a name and we can make him disappear. And that's pretty much the story of it. But it was really, really good. I was really impressed with the writing, the fluidity of it. Really enjoyed it. I might have to read more by TM Logan. Okay, our next one is newest. Oh, nope. Hold on. Number 7. New favorite author this year. And that for me is going to be Abby Jimenez, because she writes fantastic romances, nice, wholesome romances, and they just make you feel really good and feel things, you know, and you don't have all that nitty-gritty stuff, you know, with the sexy times and stuff. And I don't need to read about that. I mean, I know some people are really into that, but for me, you know, I like the romantic side of things and the build up to the relationship and that sort of stuff. So Abby Jimenez does that really, really well. In her series, A Part of Your World, or Part of Your World, not A Part. Part of Your World is just a great example of her writing and how excellent she can put a story together. Very fluid writing as well. Okay, the next one, your newest fictional crush. Well, you know, I don't really have fictional crushes. It's fiction. I mean, I can really like characters, but yeah, I don't really have fictional crushes. Number 9, new favorite character, and I'm going to say that's Dr. Jacob Maddox in Yours Truly. His character is just stellar to me. I just love the flaws and then all those good things, you know, about him and his mentality and the way he thinks and just, you know, her characters are just fantastic anyway. They're developed so well. And he's probably one of my favorite characters besides Robert Hunter. I absolutely love Robert Hunter. But they're on two different ends of the scale, really. And yeah, so I'm going to say Dr. Jacob Maddox, and we're going to throw in Robert Hunter there because he's fantastic as well. Number 10, a book that made you cry. And that one is going to be Yours Truly. That was the most recent one where I actually didn't ugly cry, but, you know, had some tears flowing. And just beautifully written. There's just some parts in that book that are just fantastic. Number 11, a book that made you happy. And that one is going to be Part of Your World by Abby Jimenez. If you guys watch my review of this, I probably exude happiness for finding this book. And this has been sitting on my shelf for a little while. This was one of my Book of the Month picks. And I know my niece had already read it and she had mentioned something about it. And then I finally told her, hey, I read Part of Your World. And now I've read Yours Truly, which is number 2, and then there's a number 3 I need to read. But yeah, this book made me extremely happy, just because it was so wholesome. That's why it made me happy. Okay, so we're on number 12, favorite book to movie adaptations. I don't really have one. I haven't watched a lot of movies lately, especially adaptations. I haven't seen any of those. But I am looking forward to watching It Ends With Us. That is by Colleen Hoover. And that is in theaters now, I believe. I'm really looking forward to seeing that one and see how that plays out because that was a very, very thought-provoking book. Very poignant and just I felt a whole bunch and I totally related to the story. So I'm looking forward to that one. Favorite video this year, and I'm assuming that's supposed to be movie. And this is gonna sound silly, but I'm gonna say Thunder Force. I just watched this movie not too long ago. I know it was before vacation, and this is with Melissa McCarthy. And anything with Melissa McCarthy, I absolutely love. But Thunder Force just had me laughing. It was goofy, fun, and I absolutely love that movie. I'm all about like rom-coms or comedies and that kind of stuff when I watch a movie. Okay, the most beautiful book you've read this year, and that one is easy, and it is How to Be a Wildflower by Katie Daisy. Now, the funny thing is about this is I bought this book to repurpose. I bought this for crafting. When I got the book and I read the book, because it's like field notes is what it is. And I think I have this in one of my book hauls. And I loved it so much, I didn't want to repurpose it. So I bought another copy. I bought this one used, and I bought another one, same place, and it wasn't in as good a condition. I'm like, that's perfect. So now I've got one to craft with, and then this one to keep for my shelves because it was absolutely amazing. Like the pictures and stuff in here, just, there's just no way that I could tear this up. It was just amazing. And I had to have one for my bookshelves. And there are parts to read as well. But yeah, absolutely love this one. Okay. What book do you need to read before the end of the year? And that is going to be The Women. I just told you that I want to finish that book before the year is over. I really, really, really want to read that. I hear really good things. And then 16 is, did I get all those? I think so. 16 is the tag others. And who is my standby? Oh, yes, it's Bobby. So, Bobby, if you have not done this mid-year freak out tag, then please do. I know Bobby watches my videos and she likes to do tags too, I think. So that is who I'm tagging. I want to thank Elaine for tagging me for in this book tag. I really appreciate that a lot, Elaine. So make sure you go visit her. Make sure you go visit. Is that Cammie? Like I said, they'll both be in the description box. But that is all I have for you guys today. Thanks for staying tuned, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.